Without the cross, we have no hope. And we realize that it is only through Jesus' sacrifice that our sins could be paid for. So now, from our perspective, we realize that the cross is good. We even call it Good Friday. Think of it like this. The worst thing that ever happened to Jesus is the best thing that ever happened to you. Without the cross, we have no hope. And we trust that he can still do that, that he can take what Satan intends for evil and he can bring good out of it, and he can do it in your life. He can do it in your church. He can give hope when you think of the situation as hopeless. As I've worked on this message all week, I got to tell you, I have tried to put myself in your shoes. And that's not easy. I'm just a guy who lives 350 miles away who is praying and pulling for your church to deepen through all of the questions and accusations and turmoil. I pray for more haystacks than pitchforks in the days ahead for you. And I realize that many of you would just love to go back 6 months ago, or you'd love to go back 10 years ago, when walking into worship had less drama, or when watching the evening news didn't make you feel like your church resembled a reality TV show. And I know you'd like for the drama to dissipate and for things to just go back to normal. But what if God doesn't want harvest to be normal? What if God needs to make some adjustments in order for harvest to be able to reach its full potential? And he just wants the leaders and he just wants the members to be teachable. What if God doesn't want you to become just another normal, go through the motions church? What if he has a bigger plan for harvest? And what if in this season he wants to correct and deepen? He wants to refine and renew this church and each and every one of us. Look, I don't know what the future holds for harvest. You all realize you don't know what might happen tomorrow. We don't know what twists and turns there might be. Who knows? God only knows. I'm encouraged by things that have happened in this last week. But I'll tell you, I don't know all of the ups and downs that will unfold in the days to come. All of the, oh, that's good, and oh, that's bad moments. But here's what I do know. I know that if the members are patiently and passionately seeking truth more than gossip, and unity more than factions, and if this church is truly rooted in God's word, and if the leaders are humbly seeking to honor God, and if this church is built on the foundation of Jesus Christ being the Son of the living God, if that's your foundation, then you can rest assured the gates of hell will not prevail against it. They can't. He rebuilds. He restores. He redeems. That's who he is. That's what he does. So let him do his work in your church. And more importantly than that, let him do his work in you. Because he who began a good work in you will be faithful to complete it.